Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I am going to explain about long transmission lines. In long transmission line, the effective length is more than 160 kilometers and the voltage range is above 100 kV. Okay, so we know that transmission line constants like resistor, inductance, capacitance and conductance of transmission lines are uniformly distributed over the entire length of the line. But so far it has been assumed that line as lumped constants. So that means in previous transmission lines, means short and medium transmission line calculations, so we considered that parameters as the lumped one. Okay, to get the reasonable accuracy, so we considered as a lumped one. If this assumption, means a lumped line constants, is applied to the long transmission lines, there will be a serious errors are introduced in the line performance calculations, because it's having more length, so that is more than 160 kilometers, right? So therefore, in long transmission line performance calculations, we have to consider the line constants are uniformly distributed throughout the entire length of the transmission line, so that we will get reasonable accuracy. So here you can see the equivalent circuit diagram, of long transmission line. So in this line constants, resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance are uniformly distributed throughout the entire length of the line, right? So in this total length of the transmission line divided into n number of sections. Total transmission line is divided into n number of sections. So in this, each section having 1 by nth value. So that means, for example, if I take this section, so in this section resistance value is R by N, inductance value is X by N, and this susceptance value is B by N, conductance value is G by N. So similarly in second section also, each section value is 1 by nth of the total value, right? So next, see here, the resistance and inductive reactance. Resistance and inductive reactance are series elements here. Okay. So next, capacitive susceptance and leakage conductance. So this is the capacitive susceptance and this one is the leakage conductance, are shunt elements. Okay. So next, see here. So this leakage susceptance is taken due to there will be a capacitance effect between the two lines, so that maybe phase to neutral or between two phases. So that capacitance effects here we consider as leakage susceptance. So next, so see here, leakage conductance. So leakage conductance is taken due to energy losses occurring through leakage over the insulators or due to corona effect. So this leakage conductance is taken due to energy losses occurring through the leakage over insulators or due to effect of corona, right? So one more important point here, the leakage current through the shunt admittance. So this is the shunt admittance. Leakage current through the shunt admittance is maximum at the sending end of the line. Okay, so this leakage current through the shunt admittance is maximum at the sending end side, and it decreases continuously when we move towards the receiving end side. So after that, at the end, so means at receiving end side, it becomes zero. So this is the brief introduction to long transmission line. In next video lecture, so I will explain analysis of long transmission lines by using rigorous method. Thank you.